They say fashion trends come and go, but there are some that should really remain gone for good. These looks were hot in the early 2000s, and that's where they need to stay.
This isn't mine. Those aren't mine. It's not mine.
Ed Hardy. Ed Hardy was one of those trends that you just couldn't escape. This brand's iconic, colorful patterns were everywhere for a while. You couldn't walk down the street without seeing people decked out in skulls, hearts, tigers, and of course the words Ed Hardy. And in our defense, celebrities weren't shy about embracing this style either. Everyone from Justin Bieber to Mariah Carey fully embraced this clothing line, and it didn't stop there. This brand also offered products like perfume, hairstyling tools, and lighters. In case covering yourself in Ed Hardy clothing just wasn't enough. So why did this trend end? According to Mr. Hardy himself, when his sales were slowing down slightly, John Gosselin from TLC's John and Kate Plus 8 was frequently spotted rocking his clothes. When John became a controversial figure, his association with the brand meant sales went from simply declining to plummeting. Yes, this means Ed Hardy was a victim of the reality TV trend. Low-rise jeans. If you find shopping for jeans to be a daunting task, we'll help you figure out what not to wear. Different styles are flattering on different body types, but ultra low-rise jeans is a trend that needs to stay in the past. Higher-waisted jeans tend to be more flattering, and letting your hips hang out is rarely a good look on anyone. Even gorgeous celebrities like Heidi Klum and Keira Knightley have tried this trend, and it's far from the best look on them. Plus, this outdated former wardrobe staple was often coupled with the other major fashion faux pas of letting your underwear stick out. If you're still unsure which jeans you should be wearing, know that mid-rise jeans tend to be the most figure-friendly for all body types. Velour tracksuits. We're all about favoring comfort over style when you don't have to leave the house. There are tons of comfy clothes options out there that still make you look polished and put together, and this isn't one of them. There was a time when velour tracksuits were all over the place, and wearers loved pairing them with some classic UGG boots. Not only were these tracksuits unflattering, but they weren't cheap either. Maybe that's why billionaire Kylie Jenner has been seen trying to bring back this trend that really needs to stay gone. This outfit is fine for lounging on the couch or surviving a laundry day, but it definitely shouldn't be a wardrobe staple. Nightgown dresses. There are so many kinds of dresses out there, from fun, flirty, casual sundresses to formal evening gowns. We're not sure exactly where on the spectrum these dresses are supposed to fall, especially since they look more like nightgowns than street clothes. These slip dresses might have looked good in the bedroom, but not so much on the red carpet. Wearing pajamas in public is rarely a good look, and this attempt to upgrade PJs to real clothes just didn't work. More recently, some stars have tried a new take on nightgown dresses, trading satin for flowing fabrics. But while these garments may offer more coverage and comfort, more often than not, they are far from flattering. Airbrushed jeans. If anyone could bring back one of these dreaded early 2000s trends, it would have to be Billie Eilish. But it's possible that even this superstar won't be able to change the public opinion on airbrushed pants. We've seen airbrushed hats and shirts, but adding graffiti-style art to jeans is a unique trend that really needs to stay in the past. Even Kanye West embraced the airbrushed style with a shirt designed to honor his late mother, Donda West, and his late father-in-law, Robert Kardashian. In theory, airbrushed jeans should be a great form of artistic expression, but in practice, this medium mixed with denim just falls flat. Trucker hats. There are tons of great hat options out there. Some serve a practical purpose like sun protection, while others can really tie a look together. But then there are trucker hats. Sure, if you're working out in the sun, these hats can function well to keep the sun out of your eyes, but they're hardly a stylish choice. Tons of celebrities like Ashton Kutcher and Britney Spears were known for wearing their Von Dutch trucker hats, and soon everyone else had them too. But instead of upgrading their outfits, these accessories tend to detract from your overall look. Wearing one of these pieces of headwear is a major downgrade, and we think these trucker hats should definitely hit the road. Capri pants. Have you ever been forced to choose between pants and shorts? Well, capri pants are kind of a compromise between the two, but they're definitely not a flattering one. Cutting your calves in half just makes legs look shorter, and is there really a need to show off your ankles? This cut of pants was all the rage back in the day, despite the fact that there are so many better options. Even Rihanna was seen wearing a rolled-up pair in 2005. She might look amazing no matter what she wears, but the rest of us should probably keep saying no to capris, especially if they're also low-rise. If you want to show off your calves and ankles, stick to wearing shorts or skirts. Statement belts. There are tons of ways to incorporate an eye-catching accessory into your outfit. Oversized earrings are a great way to dress up an outfit, and can even be added to a red carpet-ready gown. Or a statement necklace can be worn with an understated outfit to make a big impact. But statement belts are a trend that should probably stay retired. These oversized accessories were typically worn around people's natural waistlines, and they weren't exactly subtle. This particular style just helps show that bigger isn't always better when it comes to clothes. Knee-length leggings. Many of us would love to make our legs look longer, and there are plenty of tricks that actually work. If you want to visibly lengthen your limbs, try wearing a pair of nude shoes paired with a higher waistline on your bottoms. However, if you want to make your legs look way worse, try slipping on a pair of knee-length leggings. Long leggings can help you achieve a sleek silhouette, especially if you choose a dark color. But this cut is universally unflattering and can take away from an otherwise adorable outfit. We know it can be difficult to choose between rockin' bare legs or going for a pair of leggings, but either is a better option than this. The early 2000s was a weird time, when wearing jeans under dresses made perfect sense. Even though that look is also pretty controversial, it's at least more flattering than knee-length leggings. Fedoras. There have been times in history when fedoras were all the rage. This was a great look for guys in the 1920s, but it's safe to say that style has changed significantly since then. In fact, fedoras were originally intended to be worn by women in the 1880s, before men started wearing them too. But ladies made up for it in the early 2000s when tons of them were seen rocking this particular piece of headwear. Okay, so some of these outfits are totally unsalvageable, but the fedora definitely didn't help. The thing about fedoras is that they can look great when paired with the proper outfit, but there are just so few people out there who know how to wear them responsibly. Indiana Jones might have been able to pull off this look, but the average person is better off picking a different accessory. Boho skirts. There are so many great skirt options out there, and maxi skirts can be surprisingly flattering. We definitely appreciate their versatile ability to be both full coverage and flattering, but there's one version that's best left in the past. Boho style can look great when done properly, but these long, shapeless skirts just don't work. If you love the boho style, you can embrace it in so many other better ways. Just take a look at Vanessa Hudgens, who manages to capture Coachella vibes year-round and still look stylish, or Sienna Miller, who isn't afraid to rock this look no matter where she is. Short-sleeved jackets. As far as fashion trends go, layering is one of the longest lasting, and there's a good reason for that. Not only can this look incredibly stylish, but it's also functional, since you can add or remove pieces to stay warm. So while we applaud the bolero jacket for adding a little bit of warmth to our outfits, it just wasn't enough to make up for how unflattering it was. You could achieve the same amount of extra coverage by opting for a t-shirt, so these short-sleeve jackets were far from functional. And as far as form goes, they're not exactly the most awesome accessory around. We fully support dressing appropriately for the weather, but if you're trying to decide whether or not to add this piece to your closet, we recommend against it. Gaucho pants. Pieces that tend to remain timeless over the years focus on proper cuts that fit just right. There are simply some lengths that enhance our appearance while others detract from it. And gaucho pants? Yeah, they're one of the many pieces of early 2000s clothes that came in an almost universally unflattering cut. These pants were shorter than your average pair of capris, but longer than typical jeans. And instead of providing a slim fit, they were flared out in a flowy pattern. These might have been okay on beach day a long time ago, but now a stylish sundress would definitely be a better choice. You could wear a flowing maxi dress like Meghan Markle, or a silk sarong like Sofia Vergara. There's no need to sacrifice form for function, which is exactly what gaucho pants are guilty of. Long, thin scarves. There are so many different ways to wear a scarf that they're one of the most versatile accessories around. There are warm, knitted scarves, which look great in cold weather, and ones made out of cooler fabrics to add some interesting texture and color to your outfit. There are so many good options for scarves that it's crazy to think so many of us once wore these long, thin scarves. Instead of adding to a look, the ends of the scarf just hang awkwardly and detract from the overall aesthetic. Not only do they not look good, but they're definitely not gonna help keep you warm when it's cold out. Cropped cardigans. The cropped cardigan trend is a great example of when layering goes horribly wrong. Bella Hadid is always going to look like a gorgeous model, no matter what she wears, but a cropped cardigan over a bare chest is not something many people can pull off. Besides, what's the point in keeping your arms warm with a sweater if your stomach is going to be totally exposed to the elements? In the early 2000s, it seemed like everything had to be cropped, from tops to bottoms. But a cropped cardigan is simply one cut too far. A full-length sweater is much more flattering, and will do a better job of keeping you warm. Are there any of these fashion trends you refuse to give up? Or are there even more egregious fashion crimes you think we should have mentioned? Share your thoughts with us in the comment section, and then click subscribe for more great videos from the Taco. We'll see you next time!